We have learned that we use different kinds of senses to describe what we feel, what we see, what we hear, what we touch. Based on that, there are different types of adjectives. Now, the one that we spoke about, it was descriptive, because we were describing each aspect of how we are feeling, what we see, what we touch. The other one is the quantity. So we can actually describe something by describing, is it much, is it many, is it little, is it the most? So we can describe the quantity also. Then we can describe by describe by demonstrating where it is. So it becomes demonstrative. If you remember, we spoke about this, that, these, those. There we were talking about how far or close or how many were in number. Now here we are actually talking about the thing. Now I will show you the difference. Demonstrative would be this, that, these, those. So this car, those cars. So this is how we demonstrate where exactly or what we are talking about. Somewhere we use that concept of how many in number and how far it is. Then the fourth and the last one is reflexes. Reflexive is basically when you talk about yourself or someone else's. So when I'm talking about me, I will say myself. When I'm talking about him, I will say himself. Also, her, he, person. Actually, me is also a reflexive adjective. When I'm talking about I. So this is these are the types of adjectives that are there. Descriptive, we describe everything, quantity, much, many, little, then demonstrative, it can also be 4, 5, 6, demonstrative, this, that, these, those, and then reflexive. Now let's have few examples from each category. So when I say I have 5 apples. Apples is a noun. And how am I describing it, or what kind of information am I giving? I'm saying 5. I could have changed this time. I can also write delicious. I can also write yummy. I can also write crunchy. When you bite, crunch comes, so crunch. Or I can use the quantitative and I can write 4. When we are talking about demonstrative, this red. This red balloon is yours. So here I am talking about the balloon. So there are actually 2 adjectives that I am using. I am saying first the color and then I am telling them this. So there are 2 adjectives. Now how this is different? This is different because here I have a noun and then I am describing the noun by giving the place or the distance. I can also say there are those birds. Again, I am describing the birds. So it is an adjective. Let's say this is myself, herself, yourself. How it's going to add more information about a particular noun? I can say I did my homework. So when I say homework, homework is a noun. Whose is it? Yes. Mine. So, my homework. I can also say our sisters are studying together. So, here the noun is sisters. And what is the adjective? How am I giving more information? I am telling you that they are ours. So, our sisters are studying together. Another example. This must be your cat. What is the noun here? The cat. And what kind of information that I have? That it is yours. So these are the kind of adjectives that we have. We describe things, we can tell the quantity, who it belongs to. It is mine, yours, your cat, or my homework. And we can also talk about the near or how far away it is or how many in nouns. So these are the types of adjectives. Now, I am going to give you two adjectives and you have to make a sentence using both of them. So, for example, if I give you the word beach, it's a noun, and I give you the word sunset, how will you use it in a sentence? First, let me think. I can say, I love going to beach and love watching the Now, I want to make it into one sentence, so I can write and watching the dash sunset. Now, how will you fill in the blanks here? Well, I can write sandy beach and watching the lovely sunset. Now, it is your turn. Let me give you your words are man and vacation, then movie, theater. Use this in one sentence.